The world is divided into two kinds of people, those with innie belly buttons and those with outies. Rivers also have innies and outies, not belly buttons, but mouths. Where rivers flow into the sea, the land either pokes out or bends inward. But rivers don't have umbilical cords, so why do they have innies and outies? Well, coasts are the front lines between two opposing forces, land and water. In order for the ocean to invade the land, sea level either has to come up or the land has to sink down or be eroded away. And in order for the land to advance into the ocean, sea level either has to drop or the land has to build or be lifted up. Obviously, if sea level drops and then rises back again, there's no net gain on either side. But things get more complicated when a river joins the battle. For example, during the last ice age, sea levels fell by over 120 meters, and rivers cut deeper and deeper valleys to reach the falling seas. Then, about 18,000 years ago, warming temperatures began to melt the ice, and the now rising seas flooded river valleys around the world, creating giant estuaries and giving us the innie-riddled coastlines we have today. But when the steady, landward march of the seas finally began to slow about 7,000 years ago, the coastlines around the mouths of some rivers began to gain back some ground. The key factor was the sediments that rivers drop as their currents slow at the entrance to the sea. Where the sediment supply was big enough and the ocean was calm enough, the dropped dirt piled up, eventually forming new land that both lengthened the river and divided it in two. Dirt would continue to drop out and build up at the mouths of both channels, splitting the river again, and again, and again, creating a new lobe of land advancing slowly into the sea. Thus, the world's great Audi river mouths, the fertile deltas like the Nile and the Yangtze that have helped foster human civilization since its birth, all came into being at just about the same time. The same can't be said for all of the world's outie belly buttons. What can be said, though, is that innies and outies, for both rivers and people, are a small record of how we came to be. A huge thank you to the following organizations, all working towards sustainable deltas, for sponsoring this video. The Belmont Forum, the Sustainable Deltas Initiative, the National Center for Earth Surface Dynamics, the St. Anthony Falls Laboratory at the University of Minnesota, and the Deltas Project. These organizations study deltas around the world, in particular how they're threatened by human activities such as building dams, channelizing rivers, and climate change-induced sea level rise. If we don't pay attention, we might lose the landform that allowed us to become civilized in the first place.